Cooking Meals this morning, Chef Aaron Patton from Charo joins us once again, and he's helping all of you get ready for Thanksgiving by making this delicious and evenly cooked turkey. So we're going to show people actually how this works to get the turkey in there after you already cut it.
Right. So we've deboned it. We're going to have the wings, the leg, and the breast and thigh meat that's boneless. We'll all be able to cook at about a temperature of 300 degrees. And this is much easier to be able to brine in your home refrigerator, too. Brining will help make it a lot more juicy and seasoned throughout.
Okay.
So now we have our boneless breast and thigh, and all we're going to do is just kind of push it right on through and make our little turkey football.
Okay. Now, apparently this saves a lot of time as well.
What it does is by taking the bones out, it creates less to actually have to heat up and cook through.
Okay.
So it'll cut down the time. This football at 325 degrees should take about an hour to an hour and a half.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
And you could do it all kind of at the same time, though, the different parts.
Right. So you're able to control when something's done. You're able to pull it out if it's done a little bit ahead of time, give some time to rest, and make sure that it's all done when it's done.
When you season it, though, do you do it before you put it in here, or?
I like to season it afterwards. You're able to ensure that you're getting everything. Kosher salt and fresh ground black pepper will help give it a nice crunch on the skin that everybody loves.
All right. So then this is what it would look like, the finished product here. Uh-oh, your menu falling.
Yeah, so we have our drumsticks, which my brothers and I always fight over every year.
Everyone
we have
does.
The wings. Yes. And then we have the boneless breast and thigh meat. Able to slice it for ease, makes it carving a lot easier.
Okay.
And we have our cranberry sauce, a little variation that I like to do. We have our whole fresh cranberries. We use cinnamon sticks, ginger, very seasonal in this time of year for everything that goes in. A little twist is fresh lemongrass. If you take the lemongrass and just kind of break it to help release the oils, that you can kind of smell and get that whole aroma that it
and
releases.
And I tasted this. This is really good.
Yes, thank you.
So you can get lemongrass, though, pretty much anywhere?
Most produce companies in the stores will have them there in the net fresh herb section.
And how long would it take to get this all simmered together?
This simmers about in about a half hour.
Okay.
So we use a little bit of orange juice and sugar mixed with all the rest of the ingredients and just kind of cook it down by about half its volume. And there's a lot of natural pectin that will, and the cranberries that will thicken up the sauce.
All right. And so when you plate this, how do you prefer to do that?
Well, I prefer cranberry sauce over the old style gravy, so I like to just go right on a little bit of everything.
Oh, okay.
Can't be shy with.
But you could do
sauce.
The gravy as well.
Exactly. The gravy and cranberry go very well together, hand in hand, which is why it's always a battle back and forth of who prefers what.
And now you're not open on Thanksgiving, but you will be offering sort of holiday-themed leading up to the big
day. It is correct. We've got a whole bunch of turkeys in-house. I'm kind of thinking a variation of some turkey tacos or something to make it more charo-themed.
And not ground turkey tacos.
That is correct.
We're sticking with
yes,
the real meat here.
Exactly.
Chef, thank you so much for joining us this morning. And, of course, you can find this recipe on the food page of WISN.com. Also on our Facebook page, I've asked everyone at home to give us, you know, their tips as well on the perfect turkey or maybe even that sweet treat. So thank you so much, Chef, for joining us.